Hello and welcome to Designing Interfaces using the Silk UI framework. Before we get into the specifics of Silk, it's important to first understand the underlying philosophy of taking a style guide-driven approach to interface design. This paradigm states that you should first start by creating a style guide that describes how a certain brand, how a certain company's brand should be communicated. This style guide is not specific to software development, but rather it dictates how is the look and feel of all the touch points of a certain company, for example, the heading of the paper, etc. This then trickles down to the definition of the look and feel of the applications of that corporation. And once you define this overall theme of the company, it's then possible to start identifying what is the look and feel and what are the patterns that make up pages of applications of this company. This upfront approach to UI creation has many benefits. For example, you can centralize the knowledge of CSS creation and increase the uniformity of the look and feel across multiple applications. Now, Silk UI fully realizes this paradigm by changing the somewhat common approach of making up UI as you go to this upfront centralized design. Silk UI bundles inside it a collection of base themes that you can use, a set of modern UI patterns that you can also use to build your screens, and optimizations that go beyond what we normally do in web applications. To get you started with Silk UI web development, you need to have in your server at least the base framework and one or more templates. There's other support downloads that you can get from Forge that will help streamline your development by providing you samples. Each template bundle is actually made up of two components, a theme and a template module. The module is nothing more than your blank module that is already pre-prepared to use the associated theme. Once these templates are installed in your server, when you start a project, you pick a template for your app. In this screenshot, we can see a server that has multiple themes installed. It's worth noting that the web application theme you see in the top left corner is a standard responsive theme based on London, and it's not actually one of Silk UI's themes. From the OutSystems Forge, you can obtain many themes that will have specific aesthetics and target devices. The examples shown here are Dublin, Lisbon, Liverpool, and Vanilla. In previous versions of the platform, OutSystems also made available the Tokyo theme, but this is now deprecated because you're better off creating an OutSystems 10 proper mobile app. Once you have started a new application and picked the appropriate template/theme, the process of building the screens is a much more modularized approach than on classic web page development. You assemble your screens by slotting together patterns of several kinds, some larger and more structural, and some more akin to widgets. This approach yields huge benefits in terms of development time and visual harmony across your application. So let's look at some of the stuff that you will see inside Silk UI Web. First, you will find the aforementioned structure patterns. They define an overall column layout and how the screen should behave and should split for different device types and sizes. As we can see in the example, if you use a structure of two columns, which will have two placeholders, you can state in the tablet and in the phone how these panels should be split if there is not enough screen estate. So if the columns cannot all fit side by side on your device, you can opt to break at every column, on the first, on the last, don't break at all and enforce the scaling, or just break in the middle of whatever number of columns you're using. There are also responsive patterns that define the visibility and behavior of certain panels, certain areas of the screen for different device types. In the example shown on the right, you can state that a certain area will be displayed on desktop only, on desktop and tablet, and so on. This is just one of the responsive patterns available. You can opt to load certain areas only when they become visible, select a specific image depending on the device type, force a table records to pre-expand certain sections if accessed on the phone, and also opt to have sections pre-collapsed or expanded depending on the device. There is also a set of actions and functions that will allow you to tweak the code on the server side to adapt your logic depending on the device. It's worth noting that these functions only return meaningful information after the first request, because that's when the platform has obtained information about the device connecting. And this was just a scratching of the surface of all that's available in Silk UI Web. There's actually tons other patterns that you can look into the dedicated microsite that OutSystems has available for you. In closing, I would just like to reinforce the benefits, other than the huge selection of patterns that we've discussed, that Silk UI has over the standard responsive web application theme you've been using so far. For starters, the responsive behavior in Silk UI is actually implemented on the server side, so the page rendered and sent to the device is already fine-tuned to the device. The code knows the device and can act accordingly. This provides a much simpler and faster client-side experience. And if you introspect the CSS of Silk pages, you will notice that there's no media queries in the CSS, because all of the responsive is handled server-side. And this is the style guide-driven approach and Silk UI in a nutshell. Silk UI is a product in and of itself, and there's a world of benefits once you start using it in your applications.